ni jadan krain na dan ni kuntunkuni ni kobini ama fita ni tuntum edi ahini hey na sanya daye hey na wanso na etumi ada wodom muse ah Mama Kwame Usu Eric Usu ansa Ayaya nsachi ayaya nkama Amfa sempe bi amreye Oh Sana nkwe susu ono na owuo dina ne ho edi na dapache Eh Mama Usu ansa Eric, Kwame Usu to me and you know, from a bunny at two rush of form. Oh, so I saw Bembe Bembe. Now, if I could chamber in a crab war and doing and from a fat, then so I read him one. Who called Jabbe the Jambe? Eka api ma api ma nkua Enka wuni anom se Enka ombe api ma jo Obi mpe ama konto sradie ni ibi Okonto bapa Obi mpe meni ibi Ema yanko asama adon kwa jese Eno mere buwaten Sa wadi enijie ebe shia neba kwa mi usu kwain Na waye no etu Se o wo kradi yanko entu minyo Bembe mwenye mfwe Eja usu bembe Wakantina guabredia nisiswa Eja set Anthony Ade Osu wanene ma Dr. William Ade Ansa Mrs. Francisca upon mensio Mr. Chris Owusu Jemfi Wani Eja usu ansa ma Eric Owusu ansa ma Wamu njina ase Won't do take a sea to two. I'm on Takrabo, Abon Yen Yen. Yen. Na etumi ada wodom say ah Me ma kwa mi usu. Eriko usu ansa. Aya le nsechi, aya ya nkama. Anfa sempe bi amreye.
Asimu ha. Akwentu. Oh, suruwa. Akwentu na ye.
Oh, my head, Almighty Father, we bless you this morning. We thank you for your goodness and your kindness. Father, you've taught us and made us understand that in all things and everything, we should give thanks to you, O God. We come before you this morning, soaking everything that we will do here into your blood, O God. Come take us in control, even as we soak the family into your blood this morning, O God. That you will comfort because you are the great comforter. That you will strengthen because you are the God that gives strength. You will guide each and everyone here, our hearts and minds, O Father, that even in this moment, O Lord, we'll draw our minds back to you on the cross, that you will continue to work in us, O Lord, that we know that death is not the end, it's just a separation. Bless you in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Akoyene chanche wosoro Onu yakuna Beto Uwa bema Yakuma yakuna Beto
divine plan is according to his own purpose. So without wasting much time, we'd like to invite our deacon Uriel Devran to lead us in a time of praises.
Well, praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
And so we will give God praise in all things. Amen.
Amen. Our God is so good. Oh God, you are kind. Lord, you are wonderful, my Lord. You are handsome. God, you're so good. Oh God, you are kind. Lord, excellent is your name, oh, excellent is thy name, oh, excellent is thy might, oh, Lord, you are wonderful, my Lord,
you are
excellent is thy name, excellent is thy name, oh,
are so good, oh God. You are so good. Oh Lord, you are kind. Oh Lord, you are wonderful, my Lord. You are.
Lord, you are so good, oh Lord. You are so good, and you are kind.
Na enye no nyame afre no ekwe na nyu nyamu a na onyu obi akeka ibetumi akotuna twena keke and Lutin Abusia, a friend with a man, you know. Say, Emra, not your mammy John, not your Kata in your baby, yet you cry, cry, one come, cry. And district pastor, Ewaha, and then a year, Ewaha, and you will be as your mammy, Romina, Kobe, Ewaha, ma, your papa, papa. The sons, you know, young sofa, a year Reverend Prince, and I'm not Kobe, or no, so Ewaha, daddy, your papa, papa, or no. Only a Bushian ceremony or do a Baba Bo or Domo.
We'll read our Bible reading from Ecclesiastes chapter 7, verse 1 to 9. A good name is better than perfume, and the day of death better than the day of birth. For the death is the destiny of everyone. The living should take this to heart, because of the sad face is good for the heart. The heart of the wise is the house of mourning. The heart of fools is in the house of pleasure. It is better to the head to rebuke of a wise person than it is to the songs of fools, the laughter of fools. This is too meaningless. Exhortation turns a wise person into a fool, and a bribe corrupts the heart. The end of the matter is better than it is beginning, and the parents. Verse 9. Do not be quickly provoked in your spirit, for anger resides in the lap of fools. Amen.
Amen.
Oh, amen. Never pray another than soon, so now I'll be going to pin on my.
The king was sent a foot in soon, Jimu Bako, a good thing. I said, Dimpa Ayerson and Wu and the boy again. Now, Uda Ayerson, I would die. If you are Yomu Ekro Ayerson, if you are upon to Yomu Ekro. I grew up Ayerson, Syria. Now, a name of a mobile emu, now a commandam, a yan idea. A yansa for Akuma, our bobo de fee. When yansa for him, Kati Ayerson said. Obi tie nkwasiafo dwun to na so de nkase etru tri esan ase no se okwasia asirie etie eno no ye nso eye ehuhudie ani hye so obo unyansafo
I see it all through.
On behalf of the family, I would like to thank everybody for coming to support. I wish I'd not come to this.
Chris,
speak. Eric Owusu-Ansah, traditionally called Kwame Owusu-Ansah, also known as Aluta, was 55 years of age, passed away on Friday, August 6, 2021, after a brief battle with illness. Eric was born on June 6, 1966, in Kumasi, Ghana, to Mr. Seth Anthony Adair and late Madam Mary Watson. He was the oldest of five children, one preceded him in death on July 2008. Eric was educated in the State Boys School in Kumasi, Ghana. He proceeded to Pentecost Secondary School for his secondary education, where he graduated with distinction. As much as his mother insisted that education must always be the priority, he succumbed to his father's persuasion, joining him at his flat, fix, and auto body shop, where they grew their family business exponentially. This group helped bring economic prosperity to the business, which facilitated his migration to Germany a few years later. Eric married Monica Ajakum in 1992, and three children were blessed from this union. He professed his life to Christ at a young age in Roman Catholic Church in Bremen. He later joined House of Faith Ministry at former Odeon Cinema in Kumasi, where he became home cell leader and secondary Sunday school teacher. With a strong passion for spiritual excellence, he developed unmatched love for working in the church, winning souls at all costs, and cherished immensely the unique opportunity to praise the Lord. He served on several committees as well as helping others in spiritual development. He served as a protocol leader for many years till he left the shores of Ghana for Germany. Being frustrated by deep-seated dislike of living without his family, he returned back to Ghana after almost 5 years and migrated with his family to the United States of America for greener pasture in February 1998. Eric was extremely excited for joining his family once more for positive change. He never stopped planning an event that would make their sojourn a memorable one. He watched it at Church of Pentecost while in Worcester and rejoined House of Faith during his brief stay in New York City. As fate would decide, he relocated back to Massachusetts on on the slope of love to rejoin his family. Eric loved to read his Bible, praying for it and with others, spending time with his family, laughing, always wearing a smile on his face. He was a loving and caring person, affectionate father and a friend, always thinking of others first. To know him was to love him. The real passion of him was to operate behind the scene. He survived by his children, Precious, Frank, and Rachel Enza. Other survivors included siblings Christian, William, Francisca, as well as his father, Sir Anthony Adad, and the love of his life, Monica. Eric will always be remembered by his family and friends as a loving person, the man with 1,000 stories, where every story began with a beautiful, charming smile. The world has lost a great son, brother, father, and a friend. Farewell, brother.
Amen. Now, if I was so at a year in a tribute, I wore every man in one chain, I was in Dr. William Anasan at home. Amen.
And there is nothing you can't do. Oh Lord, my eyes are on you. Be magnified. Oh Lord, be magnified. Oh, be magnified. Oh Lord, you are
granted serenity in your final passage to your Maker, and indeed it has been accorded to you. Then they say, we leave a heartache that no one can heal, but love can leave a memory that no one can steal. Thank you all for joining us in this difficult time. In the face of these trying times, we take solace from the Holy Scriptures. In Habakkuk chapter number 3, verse number 17 to 19, I read, though the fig tree may not blossom, nor fruit on the vines, though the labor of olive may fall, and the field yield no food, though the flock may be cut off from the fold, and there be no herd in the straw, yet I will rejoice in the Lord. I will joy in the God of my salvation. The Lord God is my strength. He will make my feet like the hind's feet, and he will make me walk on high hills. I stand on behalf of my siblings to bid a final goodbye to my ever-smiling Eric, whose affection for family was resolute at all times. I am the second of 5 siblings, with one preceding death before this current demise. If I were to think out loud, I would say, what makes a brother to brother one of a kind? It is the way each remembers the other when they are no longer in the same realm. Life changes radically, but memories, they don't. And for that, I am eternally grateful for our being or for having a biological lineage. There is a temptation to rush to canonize your memory, but faith will not allow so. We are encouraged by how you stood tall enough as a human being of unique qualities. No need to be seen as a saint, but a treasured godly asset with prophetic assignment. Indeed, to sanctify your memory would be to miss out on the very core of your being. Your joy for life transmitted wherever you took your smile and the sparkle of unforgettable touches too. We witness your boundless energy where you could barely contain. When the threshold of your endurance was challenged, okay, let me move on. As I turned to the pages of our lives together, I realized how you were our strength in many ways than I thought especially. When our mother passed and left us under your care, this load of responsibility you carried to perfection even before the baton was officially handed to you. There were times that you preferred to be in your cozy blanket of light in a very lonely place. Aluta, we fondly call you. Thank you for being a solid rock. You were something else. Forever leading by example, maintaining dignity, duty, and decency. A combination of qualities hard to find in people today. You taught us how to keep family bond of oneness. And through this, you exemplified the very principle of a successful life. You say, keep raising the bar. If there is a hiccup, do something about it. If you fail, keep trying. Just don't ever stop. Life is like a bicycle in motion. You encourage us to cover great lengths to achieve great dreams. No matter the pitfalls, a fit early life responsibility didn't allow you to realize. But today, we are testimonies of your lifetime aspirations. Among your greatest gift was your intuition, a gift you use wisely. This is what underpins all your other wonderful attributes. And if we look to analyze what it is about you that has such a wide appeal, we find it in your instinctive feel for what was really important in our lives. You never shy away from your human struggles amidst all your innermost feelings of sufferings. You remain steadfast and secure in your faith throughout these challenging times, drawing inspiration from God's word and Adam Riku's songs, even at the twilight of your life. The world and family sense and watch your vulnerability while admiring your resilient will to change life clocks. Sometimes your genuinely good intentions were sneered at by the uninformed. You were a bit of an extrovert among us. Death, as they say, is a transition where one proceeds from the present life to another world. Without your God-given sensitivity, we would be immersed in greater ignorance of this aspiration as you held our hands together and assured us of your peace with God, even when the touch of your life was at its last throes. Those were times we will always treasure. It was as if we have been transported back to our childhood when we spent such enormous amount of time together. There is no doubt your early departure to join mom will create a void difficult to fill. But God indeed loves you more. We have questions unanswered. The uncemented bricks you gave us to build our story are still unused. Withheld tears are begging for one more day in your company. The sunflowers, the lilies, and the large greens grass looked cherry so long as you were around. Do you think they will ever look green again once the meaning of life we have lost is found? We are indeed dumbfounded. When the curtain of your life fell, however, we are encouraged by this chorus. When ocean rise and tenders roar, I will soar with you above the storm. Father, you are king over this flood. I will be still and know that you are God. Your candle has burned out, but the footprints of your impact never will. Fare thee well, Aluta. Demi Fedie. Jenny Amadihu. Catcher Auntie Mary, Nipper Joseph. Yaminsa, a woman. Yaminsa, a
woman.
I'm a man.
Tribute by Mamusua. When my father didn't have my hand, he had my back. 2020 to 2021 has been an overwhelming time, yet you allowed me to get another year with my father. You are a man full of stories, whether old memories or new moments, you were always excited to share them. Da, if I could, I would ask one more story. Da, who will tell me Mamusua Upatri Tree? The person who always made fun of me is no longer here. Although not physically present, you are and will always be with me. The process of you becoming ill, getting diagnosed with a terminal disease, was an eye-opening experience. This journey has allowed me to mature in ways I did not know now I could. During this time, I learned the true meaning of selfless love. In the midst of your traumatic events, I learned to put my frustrations and anger aside to pour the best of me. The sorrows will not be forever, but the love will. It hurts to know that I will never have my father to walk me down the aisle. or even to have my daddy daughter dance. However, I have now gained an angel who will be with me forever. Daddy, I miss you so much. Love your original favorite, Precious. And in honor of you today, I'm gonna wear my sunglasses.
Thank you for everything you have done for our family. Thank you for the sacrifices you made to ensure we were all good. Thank you for everything. The memories I remember and the ones I may not recall. Thank you for the gift of life, Dad. It brings me peace to know that you are no longer in pain. Being there for you in your time of need is by far my greatest accomplishment. I've always looked up to you, and now I can keep looking up to you in the sky. Love, your boyfriend.
Dear dog, you're at peace. You can finally rest, but that doesn't stop my tears. I still hear your voice calling me to come get you. Our car rides were priceless. It was Julia. It was truly an honor to be your daughter, to know you and to love you. You were the light in my life. Your presence was instantly recognized in the room. Words will never be able to describe the loss I feel of saying goodbye to you. Only you know how much I wish we could have more time together.
I would do anything to laugh, dance, hug, and argue with you again. I'm unsure of how long it will take me to grieve this tremendous loss. Everything I do will be for you. This bachelor's. That's all my man, my boy. All my man, my boy. All my man, my boy. Man, my boy. Yeah, all my man, my boy. Man, man, my boy. We make flow, we make. Yeah, we make flow. All my man, my boy. Papa, all my man, my boy. Papa, show you. All my man, my boy. We can't let you flow, we make. We can't let you flow. Yeah, man, man, man. All my man, my boy. We make the world beautiful, so we go.
Monica to Mr. Ansan. Love is so unconditional. Love liberates. Love is the reason why I do what I do. And so I think it's the greatest gift we have, Bibi Winers. In the early years of life, I met Mr. Ansan at the Resurrection Power Church Ashtown branch in Kumasi, Ghana. He approached me and expressed interest. We will fellowship and bond over Bible studies during our prayer meetings. We became good friends, and with time, I fell in love with this man and became his wife in 1992. He was not only my first love, but the only man I have ever known. Yes. During our marriage, we were blessed with three wonderful kids, Precious, Frankie, and Rachel. Mr. Ansan portrayed qualities of that encompass his beautiful nature and abundant spirit. He was a God-fearing man, a gracious friend to the people around him, and above all, a lovely husband and an exceptional father to our kids. His joviality and good nature attracted people, which led him to be well-respected in his community. He carried many inspiring qualities, but his ability to make everyone around him happy and comfortable was his greatest strength. From the moment he walked in, his presence was always felt. His sense of humor and contagious laughter lingered in everyone's mind. While separated, Mr. Ansah continued to show our kids unconditional love through many challenging times. This love, in quotes, this love motivated me to remain by his side until his last day on earth. Forever, I pray the Almighty Lord keep and protect your soul. The memories we shared comfort me every day. We miss you. God be with you with lots of love. Your only Monica.
You. Enya asofo ni ni so ababa baba nsa ye Reverend Ernest Asari Ewaha sofo wahana ye no akwamba ye Reverend Nana Sifa aso wahana mo akwamba Reverend Ernest akwamba biem se enyame ediye aba eyi nua Eric usu amsa akwanje imu. We shall for Yamisha Mon. Yeah. Brian, you know, you have a CT and Kakra. Now, the birthday, you will start this pretty Church of Pentecost. You so far, or Dano, and you will be a Reverend Prince Nana Kobi or her. Robin, the man of Kaba, the young Kaba.
Praise the Lord. Oh, praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
I know today is a very sad day, very tough moment for all of us. But in the midst of all these difficulties, we take courage. And also comfort ourselves. Precious. With the fact that all is not lost. With the fact that you did what you were supposed to do. You remember during the tough times, I had the opportunity to speak to all of you. These children, they are not just my church members. They are my, I have two nieces, and of course a nephew, and so forth. And I've been part of their lives as an anchor, because Monica is my dear sister. During most of the times we had to chat or talk, I've told you, and you've also made me aware that you do whatever it takes to help your daddy. And of course you did everything possible in your capacity to help your daddy and to make him stay. But that is how life sometimes plays out. A time will come according to what God has just put in place, man has already. I take comfort. You remember the day that your daddy passed away, I told you that take comfort for the fact that you fought well, you did well, you did what you're supposed to do. And so you don't have anything to put down your head. No, lift up your head. Because you did what good children are supposed to do. I know you love your daddy so much. All is not lost. Nana and the rest of the family, Uncle Peter and the wife, and the extended families, I just want to say thank you. And we bring encouragement and comfort to you for everything you did for your brother. Yes. Take comfort for the fact that all is not lost. The community that is here. As it takes lead to eternity. To my dear pastors that are here, we just want to say thank you so much for coming. We salute you, gallant soldiers of the cross, and we appreciate every bit that you are doing in this great and vast vineyard, making our master proud, and make sure we bring many to the saving knowledge of God before him, and he will tell us, well done. And before I bring the message, I want to tell my dear sister, Aunt Monica, God bless you so much for the good job and what you did for Mr. Ansa. For some time, I never understood why she is doing what she was doing. Because we are so close and dear to each other, I had the courage to praise her. And she knows everything I was. So I had a meeting with her one day. I asked my sister, why are you doing what you are doing? And it was later I spoke with one of my sisters, I won't mention her name. And she told me something that I didn't know. Later I just talked to her and realized, oh, okay. And I got it. Because I had always teased her that, hey, remember, I brought you the open file. And I had asked her that many times, Opa Branti Dudontino, Maninka Adiemun. It didn't work that way. But later I understood why she was there. She has to stop work many times. And I had opportunity to talk to the departed soul when she was alive. He was alive, Uncle Eric. I called him Akonta. And so I prayed for him at the hospital. And always Sister Monica would be there. Inyaba, Nyami Wisham, you've done what many could not do. Even most women that are still in marriage could not do what you did. So we will not stand here and just let this go by without saying that you've done well. I had an opportunity to, after praying for him, to visit. And when I prayed for him at the hospital, I told him, Akonta, I will visit you. But time was not permitting me. And
One night I had spoken with my sister and I went to bed. And in fact, that night, God spoke to me about him. And so the whole night I became so restless the whole night. And at the point I was praying that God, don't let him go. Let him stay before I go and see him. And God had told me certain things I have to go and do if I don't. And so I was praying, is it ready? Madienchi, when my papa uncle, I want to meet him. So early in the morning, sister, if you remember, early in the morning I called my sister and said, how can we meet at the hospital? Can we meet there early in the morning? And she said, yes, we can meet. So I just dressed up and we met at the hospital. So I had time with Eric. And the things God had told me to go and discuss with him, I was with him at the hospital. So I spent some quality time with him and we talked. And I told him, yes, I came here to pray for you. Of course, I knew the time is almost here. But you see, one of the things that is very difficult for pastors is sometimes you know that the end has come. But, I mean, who is unwise to go and tell somebody who is always dying? And you go tell him, say, hey, who cool? And they know pastor would do that. And so I couldn't tell him that. But I told him the reason why God said I should come. So we had a discussion and I advised him. And as we begin to chat, he began to cry. And so he cried and cried and tears were all over the place and so somebody was helping him. And I told him, I came here for this reason. I said, listen, this is the time. You have to accept Christ again as your Lord and personal Savior. Get connected back to him before it becomes too late. And I thank God that he accepted Christ again on his bed. Because that was the main reason God told me to go and visit him. And so he connected back well to his maker. And to me, that was the most important thing, the most important time. I had the opportunity to corner him a few areas and see Eric sometimes, you corner him and he would just, like a bird, he would just escape somewhere. Oh, it's true. This morning, as much as all of us were in pain and in sorrow, when I was sitting there listening to what my nieces and nephew and the family and Sister Monica and all the people, what they are saying, it's very, very, very sorrowful. But this morning, I want to share something with you. I'm not sharing anything with Eric. Eric is gone. His time has come to an end. So nothing that you tell him matters. It doesn't. So truly speaking, when we come to a funeral service like this, of course we come and mourn the departed person, but the truth of the matter is it's not about him anymore. It's not about him anymore. As much as you sob, there's nothing wrong. So you cry, you soup. Now, there's nothing wrong with that at all. Because mourning is also part of the healing process. And so we encourage you to do that. But the most important thing and the most important person in the equation is not Eric over there, but you sitting here. Officiate and just say goodbye to him. But anything that we speak, anything that we are saying here, we are saying it to you. And so I want to encourage you that you take something from this, even as we prepare and go to the cemetery. Ecclesiastes chapter 7 that we read says, verse 1, a good name is better than fine perfume. And I know most of you, you like nice perfumes. You can spend so much money to get the costly ones, the most expensive ones. I've even heard preachers, pastors, oh, maybe perfume ain't no symbol. Bible says we should not concentrate or talk about perfumes, but on earth here that we came from God, and understand that now we are baby, now we are yamin chen, and then yamin do bad as I say so. Yamin am for our betters as I say so. Whatever God brought you, and you never feel you say, oh, no. God brought you here for an assignment. That is why when you are in a pattern like this, one day you go and say, God, I brought you here.
It is as much as it's good to go to school. You need so many other wisdom, and the highest of it is the godly wisdom.
But what I want to end with you is verse number 8. It said, the end of a matter is better than beginning. And that is where I'm going. I'm sharing with you the end of the matter. You see, in as much as it's good to begin well, let me tell you the secret of life. Nobody cares, God doesn't care how much you begin. As much as it may sound good, what God cares is how you end life. The way you don't take advice when we give.
And so many people walk out, sorry, as I'm trauma. Office or bass, sorry, I'm a sofu. And yes, sofu now, bass, sorry, I'm a sofu now, so a bass only be. Sofu now, so I'm a quite young woman. So, how will your life end? The way you are living your life. And when I say how it will end, I'm not talking about the funeral home will take you. Of course, we'll get you a cemetery. But how are you going to end? The way you end will determine how you transition to the another life. But don't tell me, Chelsea. Because Abraham and Suhayao, there be. Abraham and Yadia, who said, you know, it's more than that. The rest of our life, the rest of our lives, you know, we spend in eternity. I had a near when I said 55 years. Okay? But he's going to spend so many billions of eons of years with God. So our life in the life to come is more than what we have on this earth. Maybe, you know, you may wish to go. How many years be a baby piano? One day, it will need a better day, a baby. Now saying that over corner, and it's true, and I strongly believe that they did it based on scripture. Okay, sir, so we in the papa, we tell you, I say, now, boy, bra, we soon yamie, now, we yamie, nantia, we are. Nyame ma bofo ebe fawo eko aha ne die ne yeden samsa na da wu beto no ya wadi wani yeden uya yewo angels so so mo ho mo nya angels papa omo yo bonsam omo so ba be fawo ne do ya de wako. So ask yourself, where will you be? And on a pray, as we sit here, say, Kai Obofo or Mranti Bremu, and San Adabonina de Abba. Yenia Yakwa Soreno, and Brasil Mamun Tumufo. If you name Quedia, who ye will be as be a genie? Who ye will be as be a genie? Your life does not end here. Life will continue. So the question is, how will you end? Precious Rachel and Osofo, one prayer that we are praying for you is you. I know you love your daddy. Yes, I know. Is try and leave his legacy. Make sure you leave with eternity in your mind that one day, even if you get 100 years, it will come. It saddens me when you said that at the day of your wedding, that day will come that God will provide. So take solace. So the angel of your daddy will come. And when you say, your uncle too is here. We'll do the best that we can and support you, okay? I know Rachel, there, on a minute, me know someday. Me, Anna, me, you be entering us in my hand. What's up for? Yamio, what? I'm praying that one day you will leave your name or suffer. It's a prayer I'm praying for you. Amen. I'm praying for you. Amen. Because we can't just name you or suffer for nothing. No. So I pray for you today. He's laughing. Put your suffer now. One more, so come. Bow down your heads as I pray for you. Obeshim yena kofa muku.
Oye jache wosuru.
Olu
yakuma.
Oh, man.
to so. A man saying, you know, yammy. Yammy, I told you, dear, you're from. Now, Oba. Baby, I will wait, dear. I had dang. A rather precious Esu. Rachel, and in near or suffer. And what are you asking us? When or where can we see Daddy again? Nyamia oya rechiche fo. Nyamia oni bieja. Anyanka fo papa. Esra usebe somo fraimu. Rechiche osofo ire mayen. Mayen. Eboa ebusienye na. Esre nyame se onka mhono wanshamudin. Na omwam. Oma na dum ne ne mobro hum ne na basa enye kese ewo moso. Amen. Ne nyame onka makuma ento me yam. Amen ne menyi na anye maye. Na yebeda onu nyame ase. Nyame a oni na moyi. Sampa ye ya boyi. Nyame wati. Amen. Nti enyi na anka amen kese pa. Amen. We have other one or two items on the program, after which all the people that are gathered will do the fire pass.
Singing there will be a day. Hey, what glory for the saints we share. Oh, glory, glory, glory. What singing there will be a day. Will be a day. Oh, what singing there will be out there. Ah, what singing there will be out there. When face to face with Jesus, we shall stand and join the heavenly choir in a better land. What singing there will be out there. Oh, what glory for the saints to share. Yeah, oh, glory, glory, glory. What singing there will be. Oh, glory, oh, glory, glory, glory. What singing there will be.
And I am so full, Reverend Kobe, I say. Brian B, you know, I was Yancy, a year and so forth, a year and so forth, and next, I'm sorry, ever say, or can be weak, I cry, tell Luciano.
Praise the Lord. As of bringing your Misha, or Asama, Uni, your chilling. The person may cast some cacre before. Maybe I'm Eric home. I never call me who found home, and he said, not all walk my path. We can first some watch up to 16 now. Now, Mr. Massam will say, Uncle Jesse Fee. Now, Uncle Strat will be more, no more young Henny, oh Israel. We believe you, McCoy. Someone know you will give for when you miss our so. On your phone, so. From so here, they say. But then, if you are sending an anipanicity, I'm what in ten, I'm a home of faith. And another audience say, Omo and Anna, Omo qualifies on Bayo in Israel. So when you know your coin, I'm catching the say, and you will be an ame person on your henny. Now, a man of Hano and Ningin and Diana, I said, Daddy, back up here. Oh, William. A human, a soul. And I say, Yamia catch him, say. Copy me so by the end, and I said, and to much of my David, if you move him, a bye. Someone yame kachire, someone said. Nipa shenya, chie niwa. Unyame, eshapa. Mini anum, ene, me yere Monica. Ene mwa fasifo. Adiaba kwa mi mufa, Eric honi se. Na, uwa kumapa. Mene nanda, the same baby suda, for about 3 months. I'm going to go to the house. And man, I'm a tear, Mesusa. Meaning is a macoy, dear Susada. We are seeing a way. Everybody has something that he's struggling with. Whether you are the most anointed person, whether you are the most beautiful person, whether you are the most handsome person, from my own experience and from what I've read from the Bible, no matter who you are, you have something that you're struggling for. Yes. And that shows how human we are. And that shows how we must cherish the grace of God. Eric gave his life to Christ when he was in Kumasi, before he even traveled to Germany. I know that Christ was in him because of the kind of heart that he had and the respect he had for God's word. Sir, your pamu na obi anye wa Eric Bejew. Odun no baba fori amam. Osofo ene mo maka nyina. Mo nya sa kuma ni bi.
E wo so ho no. Nyina ye begum. Aya sorry in yango. Before I sit down, I don't know why I have this song on my heart. And I will sing this song before I sit down. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Wundi man wodin Emra my bro Wundi mani da so mira Emra ma baba Enti guamio guamio guamia rabia ma batu mia ya wajuma
If you can see a Jumei, I will never fray. I'm a bio. I can't be put on the brain. I'm so young. I'm a fraying. What we have you? Dinawa, fraying. Ain't it one? What's up for this? Is for you.
I'm a friend of Minya Sofo.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
God is good.
All the time.
All the time.
God is good.
Me jina pay. Ejina ebushia ane. Eric ye mepa. Nene ya Eric Figana ni Monica ene kwa le. Kikechi na ne nka ene wo mna tsai. Na sene mi bei okwa. Na adofo a modi odo. Ebe bodo mu. Mi jina wo nyame ane. Edamos. Yamin Shiramo, Wodopa, Machre, Achrebushin, Emma, Monica, Inyasimbiya, Yamin Shiramo, Yamin Shawate, One Mawakuku, Drew Nafe Jina, a corner there, at Wakuwe. Nah, I don't know. I mean, shouting, what? I feel I'll be
disappointed.
Amen. Dear old man. Oh, back, it was a grammar. The first, me, who them, it drew a different gun about it. I'm pa. They say, oh, papa, go. They yell at Jumanua, oh, papa, fire. Gina. Peria Siachi. And see a jiddy for near the four Moshia. Bejina ha, Bejina Ebushia name, a year name, a man name. Your fashion at one of a Yamin Shirao. Jina Omina name with Damas. Yamin Shiramina, Mosem, Madaji, Ombre, Abba, say Yamekata, or Sofo, Echi.
Amen. Yes, if we still have time to go to the cemetery, you know, eventually I saw him. You see, there is no baby anymore, I don't know if you are home. Yeah.
Yeah.
And I'm going to swear, Erico. Yeah. Erico, my papa, be more. Erico, my papa. Yeah. Erico, my papa, be more. Yeah. Oh, yeah. Erico, Erico. Oh, yeah. Kakra, I'm
Oma omo ware mo omo ni jiye. Enu ti omo se sika ko ka wa. A cross da so. Fa ne fa ko. Omo ano bo ade e bo ndu ko ano. Omo ni bria in soja. Enu omo so omo di cha ko e. Ya me kan fa ho kra si. E ye mu nu ya me ma. Omo yire mo. Enu omo so e si wa de. Ano pay me jina ha na na me champo ma a me mra ne de owo ahene me pa mu chopi me ni abri ye pa me a me chocho mu cho monica ene ne ma enti na mse enti na ha no mo bi jina mi jina ha sisi ai na eye this is ta monica e mo fra no enti ena mi jina ha no sisi ai me pa mu cho Daddy, Eric. O maso mo fre wo mo nto nka. O maso mo fre wo sa wo nto mo nka. O mo wishi se nka. Be ma wo mo na sima ba akopɛ na nka o mo ti wa so nsɛm. Nka wa ka de bia ona na ma kyerɛ wo mo. Asɛ nka mo no edua ni bia na o mo ye bibia nka mo di bia yɛ dɛn aba me so mo. Daddy Eric, o ma se. Ano pɛ no. So wo nya baby na nkwa. O mo edi. Ka wo fita. Ah, Rooney Becker said, white, good. And mama say, fat, never, echo. And I almost say, Omontuma, any prayer in Suja. When you are prepared, and so. Afibia's sign, Papa Chomo Vangeli. Oma say, Afibia's sign, Afibia, I own a sign. A sign on a son, editing. Papa, a here. Papa, any hippie beer when the ma abrabu, papa di shira. As I before, and I said, before yet I can say, and nine, as we are saying, the wishra, eh, say, oh, papa do me wa, jinya kupo free nibunum, and what, sisam amon. That's all my medum wa, oh, papa, it's me jina, when I meet him, as a summon, and to a ja, and when na. I no pay me jina hamoa, the mechanic say, Munye. Munye, you know, and I must say, Monday, Afibia sign. Any Kawafita, a jammer papa, a quain. Oh, you know, Oma, so much a quain. Yame, on foul cry, and see. The Pamucho baby. Yeah, I am your sister Monica. I will share, you know, Eric. Sebi. Yeah, man, you worry woman cry war. Monica say, Nemanti or Henry called out down a teacher and no. Wouldn't so be moon view and answer woman of you. Monica say, I'm okay. Young cancer will say, Yame, Uncle Swanfa will crazy. Ogusu soon or any way soon. They be on a beyond in your main found Monica say, I'm okay. We need to apply the painting on. On also so corner na watch your honor. O coco ye goody. And what do you think? Unishia, a dear to so. Say in fact, Emma, a fire day, a cop. We are no way your son so abba no. Say, okay, Sika, and a son wa. And I said, baby, I want a mono. Say, so come on the war. No, I day. No, I to be no idea. Baby, in the house, we did no one see us here. Didn't see a in your barn. We seen any and answer or shake glasses. On the bear man, the time we sent or share no. When you near our pet, and there was so old, the honors would just acquire Amanaqua. Yes, Sister Monica say. Glasses a channel, no, near life to be no war, on any ma, near Momono, so more they cry or more aye. And Unti, and I may jump for mammy brand, ain't it, or more henny, and obey Sister Monica, may join them, Namino, and I shake glasses in, near the edge, in your bema. Eric Equine. And it's a bra Eric. Nyame, off our currency a year, we say ourselves 90 years. We must have 90 years, and a four, and then a four, and I say 90 years. Nyame, off our currency a year. And I must say, man, not at all. Thank you.
Can you be on your feet, please? Our Lord God, we are taking this corpse of our brother Eric out for burial according to your word. For you have said men shall not live here on earth forever, but is to die. The next thing that you have appointed, a time in which all souls shall assemble before you, and there we shall all give an account of our lives to you. Upon this, you have called our brother today to be with you. We commit his soul to you and ask that you keep him forever and ever. Amen.
Amen.
Shall we pray? Our Heavenly Father, we just want to thank you one more time. We thank you for our departed brother, even as we take the corpse to the cemetery, blessing that he has been with us and for us. Even as we go, may your presence be with us and help us. In the mighty name of Jesus, we are free. Shall we all say amen?
Amen.
Good. Auntie, please go the outside. We want to close the casket and so that we can go to the cemetery.
Our time is up.
Over there and wait for them. Be in your car.
There we go.
You, young brain engineers, here, Musiani, and of winning us. In our young coffee and Casana, young coffee, called not read up. Cemetery, no. And in a lot of winning, we are off in the car.
Preaching.
Thank you. Yes, mama. Larry is here. Larry will pray for us.
Meet him face to face. That is our consolation. That is our comfort. So we bring comfort to my nieces and my son. Say nyame onshamodi. Why? Na onchiche moyiraman. Amen. Ya wole ne busia. Nana ne two nanas. Oba nana ne beman. And the rest of the family. And all of those as here gathered, we just want to bring comfort and consolation to you that all is not lost. Amen.
Amen.
I am the resurrection and the life. He who believes in me will live, even though he dies. Whoever lives and believes in me will never die. Job continued to say, I know my Redeemer lives, and that in the end he will stand upon the earth. And after my skin has been destroyed, yet my flesh, I will see God. And he continued to say, we brought nothing into this world, and we can take nothing out of it. The Lord gave and the Lord has taken away. May the name of the Lord be praised. Shall we say amen?
Amen.
Life into which death can never enter. Unto him let us through our Lord Jesus Christ give glory forever and ever. Amen.
Amen.
The Lord Jesus Christ who lived and died and now lives forever, the right hand of the Father, unto him be the glory now and forevermore. Lord, you have been our dwelling place throughout all generations. Before the mountains were born, or you brought forth the earth and the world from everlasting to everlasting, you are God. You turn man back to dust, saying, return to dust, O sons of men. For 1,000 years is in your sight are like a day that has just gone by, or like a watch in the night. You sweep men away in the sleep of death. They are like the new grass of the morning, though in the morning it springs up new. By evening it is dried and withered. We are consumed by you and terrified by your indignations. You have set our iniquities before you, our secret sins in the light of your presence. And we finish our years with mourn. The length of our days is 70 years or 80. If we have the strength, yet we are spanning this trouble and sorrow. they quickly pass and fly away. Who knows the power of your anger? Teach us to number our days aright, that we may gain a heart of wisdom. Relent, O Lord, relent. How long will it be? Have compassion on your servants. Satisfy us with the morning with your unfailing love. Make us glad. For as many days as you have afflicted us, for as many years we have seen trouble. May your days be shown to your servants, your splendor to your children. At this time, we will ask you to lower the casket for us, then we continue the rest of the service. Much as it has pleased the Lord, the Almighty God, by His great mercy to take unto Himself our dear father, our brother, Eric and son, dear departed. We commit his body to the ground. Earth to earth. Ashes go back to ashes. And dust to dust. In sure and sudden hope of the resurrection. Through our Lord Jesus Christ. Who shall change our body of humiliation that we may be like his glorious body, according to the mighty working whereby he is able to subdue all things to himself. Shall we all say amen? You are busy? Any other phone? This is the final place of a human being. Our brother Eric has come to the end of his life. And you know Eric, and you know Dean Papemo. Uncle Tia said, for whom? Yes, when you say, oh, my baby, Netna. Now, Daddy, you be here. And you want him, and yes, I'm attending my room, I will be here.
But any one hour will not enter. Open me, sir. Yes, yes, yes. Emma, any adorful. This is the end of our life. Never forget that the end of a martyr is the most important thing. Live your life for God. Very soon, if Jesus doesn't come, you and I will join him. So don't ever say, I won't serve God. No. Remember your creator. We say, keep in the ball. Say, if I know, I'm ready to bar. Won't come here. You'll come to this place. Don't let it be too late. Man, your sword, don't be stubborn. The devil will try many ways to take you away from the hands of God. But you have to keep the faith. I want to encourage Precious, keep the faith. Rachel, keep the faith. Asafo, serve God all the days of your life. That is the best life anybody can live. Life is not about going about everywhere, taking everything, and killing people to get riches, and doing all sort of crazy things. That is not life. The life and the true life is only in Christ, Jesus Christ. So I want to encourage all beloved ones. Yes, yes, sir. Samri, sir, baby, we. And now that we haven't come, let's do all the best that we can to live for Christ so that when it's time, we can have a place to go. Yenia, Yenua Dinkra, the ye, them referred to ye. Amen.
Amen.
Now let's pray. Oh, it's 41 Providence Street. At the basement, we will honey a bit. Tears side of Finna, Samombra, and I'm a jump. Ye may, I'm a church, ye may, every and mame. Namuma Bwao, and near Bushia. Nayanka, Yunia, Echi, and Katano crack, 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 crack. Amen.
Amen.
The best as ye, Nunsia, right? 6 p.m. Nunsia, no about 6 p.m. to 2 a.m. And the final thing on the program is Bushia Fonda Baptism, and it thanks the community, especially there.
Ijina busua na emu ebado fu amobeja yen amaya pekura bia e dia mayinua Eric kasi yen nso a ni bitu ye mo aye yen timen na mo sin kusiasie the senti ijina busua nem kasi ya da obi biara se esese ne so se de so panyi kan kwa ba mu a mo meto aye so yen fa no manyan ko wi na kusiada yen nyina so asa ko penti kosa kwa dance so amen.
Amen. But thank you. Of course, Sunday there will be a Thanksgiving service to the Church of Pentecost, the same place. So join them. Also, on behalf of the children and the family, Canahan Funeral Home, Mama, we just want to say thank you.
Thank you.
For the great job that you people do and help the community. So we appreciate you and the work that you do. And everybody that is here, on behalf of the children, and on behalf of the family, we say thank you. God bless all of you.
God bless
amen.
You.
God bless you. God bless you. God bless you. God bless you. God